A surprise storm brings sheets of rain down on the Adventist Hospital in Ile Ife, Nigeria. A welcome gift from Mother Nature. As the clouds clear, the nursing students and other inhabitants of this small hospital compound start their day. Confronting Nigeria's ever-expanding battle against malaria, AIDS, and a lack of access to immunizations and health care for children.
Each day, the real struggle for doctors and nurses here in Nigeria is how to effectively treat the dozens of children that come into this tiny pediatric ward. The real challenge is a lack of equipment, which was helped immensely by this generous donation from the team from Bakersfield.
This is an oxygen concentrator. It's to help patients who are not breathing properly. Every now and then, one team or the other comes here, and I'm really glad that they come with things to help us to boost our supplies, but then that really helps us a great deal.
The biggest public health care challenge is water. In the country's most populated city, Lagos, only 30% of 8 million people have access to potable water. Everyone else must drink and bathe in water that is untreated and a breeding ground for parasites, especially for those living outside of the city in remote jungle locations.
We realize that poverty and ignorance are a big reason that people don't access health care. If we can come out to the villages, we not only can educate them, but we can also provide free services and drugs. And once they trust us as physicians and as nurses and as a hospital, then they're more likely to come and access our care.
Push down.
That is where the team from Bakersfield travels today, setting up shop in a tiny open-air church with a table for a pharmacy and three benches.
She is having an infection in her eyes. It's a tropical climate out here, so it can be due to contaminated hands or due to the unhygienic conditions. It can be the source.
Waterborne disease is rampant, from MIRI, or river blindness, to worms infecting the lymph system, to snail fever, transmitted when people swim or bathe. Millions are being affected by the parasites and a lack of clean water.
What we're emphasizing right now to the people out here is that they need good hand washing techniques and all. So that's the main culprit out here, what I am finding.
The team expects to see up to 300 villagers just today, with symptoms ranging from everything from fever to malaria to HIV and AIDS.
We're really focusing on malaria for one. It is a very serious issue over here in Nigeria. So we're looking for fevers, we're looking for anything respiratory-wise, if they're having difficulty breathing.
What's their trauma? Do you understand?
Even though English is the official language in Nigeria, in the jungle villages, most speak Yoruban, or language unique to their individual tribes. What is universal is the care that is given to another human being, and the gratitude that comes with it.
Thank you. Thank you.
So he's showing his appreciation that you people are doing a great work for coming here.
With a short time out to replace this hard plastic ball that's been used by the village children for years with brand new soccer balls for the tribes to share, the day is now complete for this Bakersfield team. It's back to the hospital compound for what lies ahead in a new day and a new set of challenges.